Hello Goenkans, let me introduce a new chapter called Letter to You People, which is written on page number 37 of your textbook. I suggest you people to go through page number 37 to 45 after watching this video. Okay, the first topic in this chapter is a polygon. Polygon, to understand polygon better, I have drawn here two figures. You see, there are two figures here written. So both these two figures, you will find them that they are both made up of line segments AB, BC, CD and DA. When the figure, closed figure, is made up of, when the closed figure is made up of line segments, it is called a polygon. So a polygon is a closed figure made up of line segments. Okay, the next point is that we can classify the polygons into two types. One is a convex polygon, another one is a concave polygon. Now, to understand the concave polygon first, I have drawn here a figure. When you observe it, you find this figure is also made up of line segments. But the difference is this, its one angle, angle D, is greater than 180 degree, this one. This angle is reflex angle. So in a polygon, when at least one angle is reflex angle, that is greater than 180 degree, it is called a concave polygon. Okay, this is a figure of concave polygon. And another property of concave polygon is this, that when you draw its diagonals, they lie in both regions, outside the region of polygon and inside the region of polygon. For example, if I join A and C like this, A and C. So this is a diagonal, but it lies outside the region of polygon ABCD. But when you join B and D like this, you get a diagonal that lies inside the region of polygon. Okay, so the diagonals which you draw to the concave polygon, they lie in both regions, inside the region of polygon and outside the region of polygon. So a convex polygon is a polygon wherein at least one angle is greater than 180 degree or a reflex angle. Or number two point is this, the diagonals lie in inside the region of polygon or outside the region of polygon. Okay, so this is one type of polygon. The next type of polygon is this, which is called a which is called a convex polygon. In case of convex polygon, I have drawn here two figures ABCD here, a four-sided figure and a five-sided figure, quadrilateral and pentagon. Okay, when you observe their angles, they are both either acute or obtuse angles. None of them is greater than 180 degree. So, in a polygon, when all the angles are less than 180 degree, that is, they are either acute or right angle, or they can be obtuse as well. Okay, but none of them must be greater than 180 degree. Such type of polygons are called what? They are called the convex polygon. Okay, convex polygon. So one more thing about convex polygon is this, when you draw their diagonals, they all lie inside the region of polygon. Here you will see, when you draw the diagonals, they all lie inside the region of polygon. So convex polygon is a polygon wherein all the angles are less than 180 degree. And number two point, the diagonals lie inside the region of polygon. Okay, now recapitulation, I will do it quickly like this way. Concave polygons are those polygons having at least one angle greater than 180 degree, and their diagonals lie outside as well as inside the region of polygon. But in case of convex polygon, all the angles are less than 180 degree and all the diagonals lie inside the region of polygon. Now, the next topic is a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is simply a polygon which is made up of four line segments, AB, BC, CD and DA. Okay. And in this quadrilateral, you will find it has got only two diagonals. Okay. Diagonal AC and BD. It has got four vertices. Vertices, vertex A, B, C and D. And it has got four angles, angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. And sum of these four angles is equal to 360 degree. So, quadrilateral is a four-sided figure, closed figure, or you can say four-sided polygon. It has got two diagonals, four vertices and four angles. And sum of the four angles is equal to 360 degree. It is called angle sum property of quadrilateral. Hope you understood this better. Thank you very much.